conference in the preseason predictions. Washington picked to finish number two. And UCLA comes in with a 3-0 record in Pac-12 play. Washington just 1-2 after losing 2 of 3 down in Berkeley against the Bears. And the first pitch, a ball from Gabby. What's the key for Gabby here? She struggled down in that third game against Cal. 6 walks, which is a career high for her. Only 1K. It was just a really uncharacteristic performance for Gabby. What do you think you want to see here early from her?
The only time in Pac-12 play she had more walks than strikeouts. So out of character. But for her, it's just going to be being able to adjust to the umpire's zone. She kind of kept throwing in the same spots that she liked in Berkeley. But today and this weekend, it's going to be about making those adjustments from pitch to pitch, inning to inning.
And leading off for the Bruins, Brianna Perez, the 5'7 redshirt senior out of Martinez, California. She started at shortstop every game this season. That one outside for a 2-1 count. Perez leads the squad, hitting .425. And really impressive, 7 home runs, but the speed to leg out 5 triples as well. Side. So Gabby Plain starting behind the count. A characteristic smirk from Gabby. She's dialed in with 15 Ks or can't find the either way. She usually is pretty dialed in, but always with a smile on her face as she plays at her best when she's having fun. That one outside, so a leadoff walk to Brianna Perez.
She's a dangerous one to let on the base paths, especially as the leadoff now, as they've mixed around the lineup for UCLA, but she's already stolen 9 bases so far this season, so gonna have to have their heads on a swivel.
And 9 for 10 on stolen bases for Perez. Olivia Johnson behind the plate, the battery with playing today. She's been splitting time with Jen Cummings. We got all 3 starts down at Cal. And Gabby behind the count again here to batter two. This is Savvy Pola, the outstanding freshman in right field today. She has been hitting in the 3 spot, but moving up. Because of some injury issues, Leah Jordan, with a knee injury earlier this year, has missed the last 19 games. Today, make it 20. A preseason top 10 player, unable to be in the lineup every day for the Bruins right now. And then another injury to Kinsley Washington, the 5'8 redshirt senior, injured her hand down at first base on a defensive play and is not able to go today. She was unable to go in game 3 against Arizona. And so you're seeing a real shuffling of the lineup here for Kelly Inouye Perez and the Bruins.
All the more reason she was super happy with what they were able to accomplish against the Wildcats last weekend as well. They were really able to put it together and have some people step up in key moments.
So Lance Glasso, the pitching coach for the Dogs, out to talk with Gabby Plain. And that one misses for ball two. Gabby playing the 5th-year senior. Pac-12 pitcher of the year last season. And hasn't been able to find her rhythm yet in this one. Lead off walk and now behind 2-0. And that one drops in for a strike. Polo looked like she was gonna drag, instead pulled the bat back and it was a strike.
Coach Kelly Inouye Perez also said that for Pola, she's just such a pure hitter. She's ready to swing at every single pitch. She can fight through pressure. She's not afraid of any situation.
Shows bunt again and that one drops in for a strike. Gabby playing a little nod of her head.
It's all about rhythm, especially as a pitcher, as a hitter, either way. But as a pitcher, if you're trying to get your groove back, it's just about feeling comfortable and getting in that rhythm, being on the same page with your catcher.
Ball put in play, and that one under the diving mitt and into the outfield for the first hit of the game. So two runners aboard and no outs here in the top of the first.
Take a look at this again. See, she throws the hands, gets just enough. Lets that ball travel a little bit deep with that outside pitch and able to poke it through the infield. Nice base hit.
Under the mitt of Riley Holtorf, the freshman at third base. And a C&I single there for Savvy Pola. And so a dangerous spot here for the UCLA Bruin offense. And Gabby Plain with ball one, her third straight batter, trailing behind.
Gabby gonna wanna stay in the zone and around it. Anything wild right now, there's a ton of speed on second base with Perez, and she could move up 60 feet pretty easily, so gonna wanna keep it clean.
Nice pitch down low, catches the corner for strike one on Delaney Wiz, the catcher for the Bruins. Redshirt senior at Amorcut, California. Six bombs this season for the senior. One swing of the bat, she can make this 3-0. That's what she does. And a swing and a miss. Who's going for the fences on that one?
I think when we were looking at the game notes coming into this weekend too, she was described as a certified bopper. Just a tad late on that swing, but you can tell just gets that barrel through the zone for a long time, that extension. If she gets a hold of one, it's out of here.
Your left foot right on the chalk with the open stance. Delivers this one right down the right field line. That is gonna plate Perez. And the double off the bat of Delaney Wiz. Good piece of hitting there, going with the pitch, sends it into right field down the line, and one run already in, and no outs.
Again, going with that outside pitch. Look at the plate coverage by Delaney Wiz. Down in the zone a little bit, just slices right through the middle of the ball, keeping it fair. And that walk with Bree Perez coming around to bite the Huskies a little bit.
Leadoff walks will kill ya. And already Perez coming around to score. Runners at second and third for the cleanup hitter. And she is a good one. Maya Brady, the 5'10 redshirt sophomore at Thousand Oaks, California, with 9 home runs already this season, 3 doubles. In her young career, already has 30 career home runs. Falls behind 2-0, so Gabby Plain has seen 4 batters and she has fallen behind in the count to all 4. She had those career high 6 walks last week in Berkeley. As you mentioned, the first time in Pac-12 regular season play she's ever had more walks than strikeouts. And so far today just hasn't quite found that groove. Swinging bunt here, fielded by the third baseman, Riley Holtorf, to get the first out of the inning. And a run will come in, so the RBI ground out for Brady.
And that's what you call a productive out or an intelligent out in that situation. You put the ball on the ground, you got some speed on third base, able to read it and score. Even though you're not on first base yourself getting a hit, you're still able to be productive for your team with the RBI.
And some good base running by Pola. Wait until Holtorf or Holtorf, excuse me, threw it across the diamond and then took off for home. So one away with this Bruin offense and runner in scoring position. This is Seneca Kuro, the first baseman. And that bunt dragged foul.
I like that read of the defense. You can see that the corners were playing back in that situation. Why not? Why not try something? Try to lay something down, and you don't just have to be the lefty slapper to play a little bit of small ball. If you have some speed and you can read that, it's a good idea.
These Bruins have so much production up and down their lineup. Kuro hitting in the five spot, the first baseman. Fouls that one back for strike two. So the 1-2 count. Kuro hitting 361 this season, a pair of doubles, but is absolutely tearing it up over her last 10 games, has 10 ribbies and hitting 615.
That'll get you back in the lineup.
Yeah, I think you'll find your way in there if you're on a streak like that. Had two RBI singles to left in game one versus Arizona last weekend. Off the end of the bat there. Nice play by the freshman on the move. Riley Holtorf. A couple of fine looking defensive plays for the true freshman. And Megan Faramo, you've heard about her as a pitcher. How about her first career bomb?
And she came into UCLA as a two-way player. That ball got out of there in a hurry. Tons of power. I mean, you see it on the pitching side, but to be able to see her getting that opportunity to hit has been special.
Now that thing left the yard in a hurry. And for the first time in the lineup, it's Gabby getting ahead of a hitter. Strike one to Faramo. So five straight batters. She started with ball one. And Faramo has got some ridiculous power. This swing and miss. And it's 0-2. UCLA head coach Kelly Inouye Perez said that Megan Faramo has more power than anybody on her team. That's saying something. She's your pitcher, your All-American pitcher.
And with the rest of the bats they have in the lineup, wow.
Exactly. That ball getting away from Olivia Johnson, and the play at the plate not in time. So the pass ball slash wild pitch, that one in the dirt. Regardless of how it's scored, it's another run on the board for the Bruins. The fans here in attendance loving that one.
That's the thing about UCLA. Not only are they going to punch you in the mouth, but they will capitalize on any mistakes, whether it's that leadoff walk, a wild pitch, a pass ball. They're going to be all over it.
That was Delaney Wiz. And a swing and a miss, the first K of the game for Gabby Plain. But UCLA is your third baseman, and Seneca Kuro over at first. And the catcher for your Bruins is Delaney Wiz. With the double down the right field line. And get the Bruins offense out to a great start. This is the true freshman. And takes strike one to even the count.
She's coming off of a hot weekend down in Berkeley, too. Hit two home runs against Cal on Sunday, even during the loss. Freshman of the week in Pac-12 the week before that. Reached base 8 consecutive games in a row on a streak right now. If she can get things going for the Huskies, it'll be good.
Already with 7 home runs this season as she takes strike two on the outside corner. hit two home runs in game three versus Cal. So swinging a hot bat right now. She was 2 for 4 with those two bombs, 4 ribbies. And she also has 8 stolen bases, which is 4th best in the Pac-12 conference. That went upstairs to even the count of 2.
And the Huskies are going to need that. They're going to need the newcomers as well as the veterans to really step up 1 through 9. They're still trying to figure out how to play Husky softball. That's the way Heather Tarr phrased it. But, you know, when you have departures like Sis Bates, Taryn Atley, Morgan Flores, they might not be totally rebuilding, but they're reloading.
Yeah, you lose someone like Sis Bates and also Morgan Flores, who was the outstanding catcher, who was here for 6 years. See Sis Bates, no shock, she's in the middle dancing, got the gum going.
Always with the gum, that's her thing.
With the great energy in the dugout, she's now a volunteer assistant coach for Heather Tarr. So she's still in there in the dugout, but I'm sure there'll be a lot of people would love to see her out on the field. I want to welcome in our viewers just watching lacrosse. UCLA jumping on top of Washington. And the first out of the bottom of the first is a K by the outstanding Megan Faremo. It's her 150th K of the season. She sends fielder down on strikes. And now this is a battle that you do not want to miss. One of the best pitchers and one of the best hitters in the nation with Bailey Klingler in the box. And she sends this one high into the air near the fence, and that one is gone. Bailey Klingler with her 14th home run. What a star.
It only took one pitch for her to do it. That was a tower down the third baseline out in left field. Still leading the Pac-12 in home runs and RBIs for a reason. This is best on best here. Best hitter in the pack, best pitcher in the country. Just absolutely lifts this one up and in, belt high. Woo.
Man, her swing is explosive. This thing carried just to the right of that foul pole. And Huskies on the board. You mentioned it, first pitch swinging up in the zone, and she took that one out of here.
And it's important to answer like that. When you give up a big top of the inning like that, 3 runs to UCLA, you do want to answer with something in the bottom of the inning and get that momentum swinging back your way a little bit. And that's the type of player that Bailey Klingler is.
Bailey Klingler hitting in the 2 spot. Heather Tarr has had to work her lineup around. Sammy Reynolds with the concussion is in concussion protocol. And this one driven off the wall. Madison Husky is going to slide into 2nd. So back-to-back extra base hits. The Klingler home run and now the double from Husky.
That is huge. That is clutch. Keeping the momentum in your favor. A little bit too much white on that plate, and she takes it for a ride out in right center. That's huge for the Dogs.
Outside pitch. She went with it. Off the opposite field wall. That one was a screaming line drive, and now the cleanup hitter. True freshman Olivia Johnson catches the inside part of the plate for 1. Olivia Johnson, what a start she had to her career. An epic start. It's like, who is this kid just ripping it up? Hit 2 home runs in her first game as a Husky. And already with 5 home runs this season. At a Pearland, Texas, and Dawson High School. And getting a start behind the plate today. just underneath that one. And that one is out number two for the Huskies. Called in by Perez. And so runner in scoring position. Huskies trailing 3-1.
That reminds me of what Coach Inoue Perez told us when we had a chance to talk to her, which is the Lisa Fernandez stat that they track for their pitchers. You give up a hit, the next hitter needs to be out. Now she gave up the double after the home run, but getting that pop-up was key for Megan Faramo in this inning.
And she gets a big swing and a miss from the dangerous Kelly Lynch for strike one. Kelly Lynch, a couple of home runs this season, three doubles, hitting 283. And she takes a look at strike two.
And that run that Megan Faramo gave up on that home run was the first run she's allowed in 20 days since Texas A&M back on March 5th.
Wow.
So the first run in 20 innings that she's given up.
Lynch trying to get this one, but that one is in fair territory.
9
due up for the Bruins. Anna Bynes, the second baseman, will lead things off in the top of the second. And she fouls that one back.
Just that pitch right there. Gabby Plain able to get first pitch strike coming out in this second inning shows a little bit of an adjustment. Now she's going to want to stack strikes or keep attacking the zone and get ahead of these hitters. It's really mostly a mental adjustment. Yes, you're doing different things physically to make sure that you're able to pitch that ball in a certain location, but it's mainly that mental piece.
And she gets ahead 0-2. In the first inning for Gabby Plain, she fell behind 5 straight batters. Finally got strike one to Megan Faramo and eventually struck her out. So now back-to-back batters, if you go back to last inning, she was able to get ahead. See if maybe the ace of the Huskies will get settled in. And she gets a swing and a miss from Bynes for strikeout number two and back-to-back Ks.
That's what we're used to seeing from Gabby Plain right there. Check out this drop ball. Ooh, just drops right off the table, the location, when you're ahead in the count like that too, a little bit off the plate. That is a pitcher's pitch. Beautiful.
Now, on the way Gabby Plain pitches too, she needs those corners. And when she's ahead, she's lethal. If she gets behind, it's a totally different story for the All-America, just like any pitcher. Strike one is your best friend.
Yes, and we talked about how she's not going to overpower you with the velo necessarily. That's really not her game. It's the movement and the location spotting that is key for her.
So Anna Bynes striking out for out number one. Jayla Castro, the DP, in the box now. And the count evens at 1-1.
She looks a little bit more relaxed, too, in the circle, a little more so than the first inning. We did see the smirk in the first inning, but.
Smirk maybe for a different reason.
Yeah.
And gets another swing through.
That pitch is so hard to lay off. It looks so good, and then it just dips out of nowhere.
You got bad intentions when you're in the box with that pitch, and then you're thinking, where did it go? Gabby, how'd you do me like that? Castro, the 5'5 freshman catcher, and she takes a look at strike three. So two Ks in a row for Gabby.
Look at this again. Her bread and butter, another drop ball. Gosh, any hesitation with Gabby Plain and you're done for.
kind of a little half swing, half-hearted, didn't know where the ball was by Castro. So two down and the nine hitter, Kelly Gooden, the left fielder. Try to turn the lineup over. And Gabby gets ahead again. So three of the last four batters now, she has delivered strike one. Gooden with good speed in 327.
Spot too that can really act as almost another leadoff. You know, she's a two-time all-regional player, all Pac-12 recognition throughout her career. You know, hitting 327 in the ninth spot, that used to not be a thing necessarily.
Right. Well, eight of the nine batters in UCLA's lineup today hitting over 300. So even the nine hitter there at 327. And she takes a look at ball two. Six redshirt junior Kelly Gooden out of Seal Beach, California, Monterey High School. I remember when she stepped foot on campus for the first time and Coach Inouye Perez saying she is super fast. So I just remember she puts this one on the ground and nice scoop play over there at the hot corner. Three plays over
great Bruin. Kirk Walker in his 21st season at UCLA, also a Bruin alum.
And Faremo will get things started here to the sixth hitter in the Husky lineup, Lily Yeagan, the left fielder today for the Dogs.
It's like the ultimate sign of trust when you're a former battery who played together at your alma mater, and then you're both back in the coaching staff like Lisa and Kelly. It's kind of the dream.
It is interesting how so many catchers make good head coaches slash managers in both softball, baseball.
You're having to manage a lot of personalities with the pitchers and understand the game as a whole. Just look at it holistically when you're looking at hitters, etc. So it really does make sense. Transferable skills.
Ball in play. And that throw in the dirt. And unable to pick it. Seneca Kuro. The throw, and Huskies have the leadoff hitter aboard.
This is how speed puts pressure on the defense, too. Really have to get rid of it. Has to be a perfect play from Perez for this to work. She has to have field it perfectly, transfer the ball into her hand, throw it perfectly. Everything had to be perfect, and when you have speed like that, it makes it tough.
So the leadoff hitter aboard for the Huskies. As they look up at a 3-1 deficit. So Jadelyn Alchin, the center fielder, in the box for the first time today against the outstanding Megan Faremo.
I don't know if her batting average really reflects where she's at currently in the season either. You know, she had a walk-off bomb to win game two down in Berkeley last weekend.
One up high, so getting ahead of the count here at 2-0. 5'6 junior, you mentioned it, hit just 136 as a junior this season. But last year, as a sophomore, hit 301 with six bombs. As a freshman, hit 294 with two bombs. So she definitely has proven that she can hit at the highest level. And that's how softball works sometimes. Getting a little bit of a slump, you got to work your way out of it.
When you have versatility on a team the way Washington and UCLA, as a matter of fact, do, you know, there are options, people who can step in and hit.
Gets underneath that one, popped up. And out number one of the inning as Perez squeezes her mitt around it. So one on, one away here in the bottom of the second.
Now every time Megan Faremo gets an out after giving up a hit of any kind. I still think of that Lisa Fernandez stat just because she was so good at it. That's why they named it after her. Kind of funny that she's still a part of the staff. Right. So they're still using her name, but that's what happens when you're the GOAT.
So Riley Holtorf, a true freshman who's already made three good-looking defensive plays at third in this one. The 5'8 freshman from Phoenix, Arizona, Sandra Day O'Connor High School.
And you said it, I've been very impressed with her defense over at third base. We've mainly seen Klingler or Silent Rain Espinoza over at the hot corner for this Husky team, but she's been holding it down really nicely over there.
Big hack there, and she swings through it, throw down to first. And Agan back in time. Riley Holtorf, the Gatorade Arizona Player of the Year, winning a state title back in 2019. Committed to UW all the way back freshman year in high school. Knew this is where she wanted to be. And comes from a big baseball, softball family. Her dad, Ronnie, played baseball at Grand Canyon, and her mom playing softball at New Mexico State. And she'll get the pass down to first base as that one looked like it nicked her.
Any way that the Huskies can find themselves on base is going to be key for them. Looks like it just got her back leg just a touch.
I mean, if you're going to get hit by a pitch and get down to first, that's the way you do it.
It's Megan Faramo, right? Like, let's just take what we can get.
Take the seam of the pants and take a little bit of contact. Yep, I'm heading down to first, you bet. So just one away here, and now runners at first and second. Megan Vandegrift lets that one trail for ball one. And really a good story for Vandegrift, local product out of Buckley, Washington, White River High School. And she's a middle infielder. And if you didn't know, UW has had some phenomenal middle infielders here for the last three, four, 5 years. People forget Sis Bates didn't start as a shortstop. She actually started at second because Allie Aguilar was playing shortstop when she got to UW. But Vandegrift has kind of played behind and a supporting role this time, this season. As she lays down the bunt, moves the runners over. So second and third for the top of the lineup. Kinsey Fiedler up next. But for Vandegrift, she's getting her shot now and taking advantage of it, hitting over 350 here in her senior season.
I loved how Heather Tarr just referred to her as a Husky through and through. That's one of the biggest compliments you can get from a coach, but also a coach like Heather Tarr, who is pretty much synonymous with Husky softball.
Heather Tarr, of course, playing here. Third baseman, first team all Pac-10 when she was a player. Made it all the way to the national championship game in the early seasons of Washington softball. The program originated in 1992 when she was on campus here at UW in 1993. And took over for Teresa Wilson. There's only been two coaches in the history of Washington softball. What a great job she's done. National champion back in 2009 and had her string of three straight trips to the College World Series interrupted last year when the Huskies, frankly, were underseeded.
Yes.
And a lot of irritated people as they got sent to Oklahoma.
I remember talking with her just leading up to the selection show before it had actually happened, and she was talking a lot about, oh yeah, we want to host twice, you know, in postseason. We want to host regionals, super regionals. That's where their head was at before getting the 16 seed.
Oh, and Megan Faramo with a big at UCLA. The Olympian. Oh, good swing here. And that one is fair down the left field line, bouncing off the wall, and a stand-up double for Perez. First pitch swinging, wasting no time.
That may be a good approach really for both lineups in this way, in the sense of go after a good first pitch if you get one from Gabby Plain. And that one is a little bit too far over the plate. Gets all of it. I mean, that was an absolute rope.
Lasered out to the left field wall.
Attack early in the zone, though. If you get something good early, go for it. It only gets harder the further you go in these at-bats.
No question. The sixth double of the season for Perez. So runner in scoring position here. No outs for Savannah Pola. Savvy, and that ball gets away from Olivia Johnson. And Perez right on top of that and gets into third.
Talking about her speed, that is huge. That 60 feet between second and third makes a huge difference, especially with less than two outs. There are so many ways that she can score from third base. A sac fly, a pass ball, a wild pitch. There's so many more ways you can score when you're only 60 feet away like that. So that's a big advancement.
Comebacker to Gabby, freezes the runner, goes over to, oh, and the ball is dropped. They say, okay, on the transfer, Kelly Lynch had it in her mitt and it pops out. And so Kelly Inouye Perez, we're down to talk to Mark Craver, the first base umpire. You can see she dropped the ball. And so I think Mark Craver saying it was on the transfer. It looked like it popped out of the glove to me.
It did.
Yeah.
There's a bit of a delay before it popped out, so she does make the catch.
She secure the catch.
She has it there, and then it comes out. Oof.
Nope.
Yeah, see, Kelly Eyes making sure there's a conversation, and there's Lisa as well.
I don't think she ever completed the catch.
And that makes a difference, right? You go from the possibility of having runners on first and third with no outs to having an out with just the runner on third base.
Well, a nice defensive play by Gabby Plain, who fields her position like the All-American that she is. The comebacker to her. And she freezes Perez over at third base and then makes the throw over to first. And low, pops out of the mitt of Johnson. So the true freshman, Olivia Johnson, behind the dish today.
Getting back in a groove behind there as well, just given that Jen Cummings got the start for all three games at Cal last weekend. They've been splitting time, but there's nothing like game reps, so it's about getting used to that rhythm again.
Beautiful spot there by playing right at the knees of Delaney Wiz. And well ahead in the count, 0-2. Wiz behind home plate to catch Megan Faramo's two perfect games earlier this season. She also split a perfect game. And the swing and a miss, the whiff. Gabby Plain with her third K of the evening.
This is when you can be the most successful as a pitcher. Gabby Plain been working that drop ball a lot during this game. And then when you change planes like that and go upstairs, that's what's going to keep these hitters off balance.
Another dangerous hitter stepping into the box for the Bruins. Maya Brady, the center fielder. Five-ten, good size, swinging it from the left side. Out of Oaks Christian High School in Thousand Oaks.
One of my favorite moments on Twitter ever had to be when her uncle Tom Brady said that she was the most athletic person in the family, hands down. Definitely one of my favorite Twitter moments of all time.
And Maya says, you bet.
I know, she owned it, which I loved even more. It's awesome.
Her mom's brother, Maureen, is her mom. Her mom was a star pitcher at Fresno State, All-American. And Tom Brady, of course, you heard of him He's back with Tampa Bay, baby. Retirement. He was just fooling everybody. I never believed it, and I'm not going to believe it. He was too good last year to walk away. He's not done playing around with everybody. But he's a big supporter of Maya.
He's talked with the UCLA team, too, done some Zoom meetings, inspirational chats. Really cool to see that involvement.
How cool is that? Comebacker to Gabby Plain, two outs, now make it three. So after the double coming into today, eight doubles, two triples, 43 ribbies. And I think maybe the most impressive thing is that in 86 at-bats, she has only struck out five times. That's remarkable. When she has 14 home runs and the way she swings the bat, she's got excellent control to go along with that power.
She is the epitome of a tough out, that's for sure.
Second team All-American a year ago. That one outside. And if you're Megan Faramo and you see Klingler already has come up and got on the board with the solo shot, where are you trying to pitch her? How do you attack her?
You want to just stay on the corners or slightly off the plate, maybe live in that river area or with the off speed. That's a good idea, just seeing that there from Megan Faramo. Trying to change speeds, change planes, but nothing over the wide of the plate. You just can't get away with it. I mean, she can hit balls that are outside of the zone as well. So keeping it down in the zone, that was maybe the mistake last time, a little too high, belt high. Keep it down and you'll keep it in the ballpark.
And outside. So the 3-1 count to Klingler. This is an All-American versus All-American matchup. Faramo, 11-1 this season, 150 Ks. Klingler sticks her bat out, sends it to right field, but that one is hauled in. The defense lined up correctly and not having to move very far was Savvy Pola.
It's a big out, considering what she did last time. UCLA still has the lead, but they haven't scored the past couple innings. So just trying to keep that momentum on their side and not letting Washington creep too much further back into this game.
So the fly out to right field for Klingler. And Madison Husky with the double. Back in the first inning. Right field here today. Just underneath that one, and it is fouled back in the stands. Nice crowd out here on a Friday evening in Seattle. And the fans ecstatic to be back in the stands. Special happy birthday shout out to one of the Husky softball's biggest fans, Popcorn Patty. Stopped by to say hi before the game. One of my favorites. It's her 76th birthday today, so happy birthday to Popcorn Patty. He's out there somewhere in the stands, having a good time and rooting on the Huskies.
She said it had been 2 years since she was able to come and see them play in person. What a birthday treat. Love that.
Yeah, the fans full in the outfield and really nice crowd. Of course, the top 10 showdown is one you don't want to miss. UCLA has won 18 games in a row. They're the third-ranked team in the nation. And this matchup always is competitive. Some of the best softball players in the nation on both sides.
And in those 18 games, eight were run rules, too. So when we talk about the offensive production of UCLA, we mean it.
Well, and also the three shutouts last weekend versus Arizona. It's the first time they've done that against Arizona since 1989. And that's another, it was a top 10 matchup. Arizona last weekend ranked number 9, UCLA ranked number 3.
I loved how Kelly I said the girls told her, hey coach, you know that was the first time since 89 we've done that? And she was like, yeah, that was my freshman year.
She's like, don't try. Coach Kelly I with UCLA softball trivia. She's been a part of almost all of it. I think this is her 34th year in a row at UCLA between being a player, an assistant, and the head coach. That's remarkable. And it's always so much fun to talk to her. She said, I'm sick of my own voice by now, but I don't know about for you. Every time I get to talk to her, it's just a treat because she's really good. You mentioned as a former catcher how she handles players and her comments and how to motivate and what she does. It's just really impressive. Year after year, the consistency, and they're bringing in one of the top-ranked recruiting classes in the nation next year. They just keep on ticking. Olivia Johnson gets underneath this one, and just on the line, it is taken in for ground out in the first. And Gabby Plain in the circle for the Huskies, the 2021 Pac-12 Pitcher of the Year. Gabby was in the Olympics in Tokyo in the offseason with Team Australia. She was the first player in the history of Washington's program that did not come from either the U.S. or Canada. And what an absolute star that she has been in the circle for Washington now in her fifth season.
That's a legacy that Heather Tarr has done a great job of building here at UW, which is just that international presence, the Olympians that have been on the team, that Team Canada, people like Danielle Laurie, Victoria Hayward, Jen Salling, all going to be honored tomorrow at the game.
Yeah, that's going to be great. This ball put in play, and another one handled easily from the true freshman, Riley Holtorf. That'll be fun tomorrow for you fans that are in the area. Only one number has been retired in Husky history, and that's for Danielle Laurie, her number 15. Sits out on the right field wall. Heather Tarr doesn't have her number retired. She probably should by now. National championship winning coach. This ball up the middle, a C&I single right through the gap of the shortstop and second baseman. So Megan Foremo clapping her hands together. And this is where every announcer says helping her own cause as the pitcher standing over at first base right now and trying to add on to her 3-1 lead.
And standing next to one of the players who was the best ever at it with Lisa Fernandez too. Yeah. Speaking of legacies, that is something that UCLA has built generation after generation with Bruin softball. It's those pitchers who rake, as they say. You're just able to help yourself out on both sides of the ball.
Yeah, we were marveling going over the career numbers of Lisa Fernandez. Her ERA over her career was 0.21. Looked like that ball might have been fouled, and so Foremo hustling back to first, or maybe it was just a swing and a miss. Foremo not really used to running the bases over there as a chuckle.
Getting used to it again. Although last weekend, you know, she ran all the way around with that home run. So she's like, wait, I have to be on first base again?
She just is such an athlete. 6 feet tall down at first base right now. If you were going to build a softball frame to be a pitcher, you would say Megan Foremo. Yeah, she's a pretty good model for that. Redshirt junior as an alternate on the U.S. national team. The count now 2-1. Nina Vines struck out against Gabby Plain back in the second. Pops this one up. Will it stay fair? Over in a little crevice in between the stands and the wall, and it's hard for us to see, but I think Kelly Lynch got there. The stands breaks up before the bullpen, and there's a little area. And a good hustle play by Lynch to get over there and make the grab.
I mean, this is just an excellent job of spatial awareness.
Ooh, And there was a collision. I could not see that. I was blocked off.
That's where the communication has to come in, but just both of them even getting there on that ball and knowing that they had the room to make that catch. Also helpful when you know the field really well and know that area.
And Kelly Lynch has been playing first base a lot so far this season, but for Kinsey Fiedler, the true freshman, she's played sparingly at second. She's played some shortstop. She's played some center. She's moved all over the place. And so, yeah, that communication on the pop fly right there, you can see the look on Fiedler's face. Like, I don't think she ever saw Lynch. I think she was so focused in on grabbing that pop-up, and she hit the deck. And thankfully, she's okay. Those kind of collisions are scary. Gabby Plain making that ball move and gets the swing and a miss.
Curveball had nice movement, like you mentioned, Elise. She went with the drop ball a lot last time around against Jayla Castro and was successful with it. We'll see if she mixes it in again.
So two down, Faremo at first base.
There it was. Wow, that was pretty. But that's the thing with these pitchers. They're just going to keep throwing it until you make the adjustment. It's a situation where she might throw it again, right? It's like until they prove that they can hit that off you, you keep going with it.
See the wristband on that left wrist with all the pitches. We'll see what she dials up here. 1-2. Oh, and she gets her again. Oh, Gabby Plain. Kelly Lynch flew out in the first in the box here to get things going in the bottom of the fourth. Faremo missing with offering number one here. Kelly Lynch, two-way player for the Huskies. Pitches and hits, hitting 283 this season. All the way from East Coweta, Georgia, about 40 miles outside of Atlanta. Two players from the state of Georgia in the lineup today for the Dogs. Lily Agan, the sophomore out of Noonan, Georgia. And the two actually went to the same high school, East Coweta High School. As Lynch pops up for the second time today.
She, along with the rest of the Husky bullpen with the pitchers, there's five on the roster, four others outside of Gabby Plain. You know, they've been a key to this versatility that Washington has been utilizing as well this season.
Agan swings through that one. She got on base, hitting it to the shortstop, Anna Perez, and beat it out. Her speed forcing a throwing error, but got stuck in the base pass. Gets this one in the dirt right here. Another tough play coming up. And as she is out, nice play on the move for the third baseman here today. It's Tessa Malaulu.
The range, just cutting the pie right down the middle across in front of Brianna Perez. And see, that actually makes a huge difference in terms of timing, because Perez has a lot more ground to cover to charge in on that. But Malaulu able to just cut it off and make that quick throw.
Yeah, big hack there from Jadelyn Alchin, a junior from Huntington Beach, California. So two down. Faremo looking for another 1-2-3 inning here against Washington. Ooh, blowing that one by Alchin. Strike two.
That up and in pitch is tough, because all it does is look like right there. It's right by your eyes, so it's hard to lay off that pitch.
On another one. Big hack, swing and a miss. Three off walk coming around to Burner. One of the three runs scored in the top of the first. And we are now in the top of the fifth. Same 3-1 score that we had to finish the first. This is Kelly Gooden, the left fielder, the 9 hitter with great speed. They're trying to turn this lineup over to Brianna Perez in the top of the order.
Put her in that 9 spot, in that position. We said it before, she can be like another leadoff hitter. She's a slapper, got a lot of speed. And one thing's for sure, it's hard to get anything solid off of Gabby Plain, so if you can just poke something into the infield, chop something up that you can run out, then you can get things going for the Bruins.
That one hit me outside half of the plate. For strike one, 2-1 the count.
We talked about Gabby Plain's trademark smirk, but also the two braids into the low bun. I feel like it's a trademark of hers as well.
Hey, man. The success that she's had, I would be sticking with the same routine.
I actually asked her about it once. I got to talk with her on the Believe in Softball podcast, and she said, you know, it's just if I'm able to get in line to have everybody on the team who braid my hair. If not, you know, I just kind of throw it back. But if I'm able to get in there, then I will. And I just found out leading up into this weekend that there is an Instagram account for the Huskies and their hairdos. It's called Doggy Do's. And it's run by Megan Vandegrift, Silent Rain Espinoza, and a couple other players. And they literally showcase their hairdos every game.
I think that's outstanding. So then you want to mix it up a little bit. You can't have the same photo all the time. But I'm going to say the superstitious will wear the same hair every game as long as it's working. And Gabby Plain, it's working for her today. 6 Ks, just 1 walk for the All-American.
Look where she's able to mix these pitches, the rise ball. See, when your drop ball is working that well, like she's been able to do that since the first inning, then when you mix in this pitch, gosh, it's hard to hit off you.
So she K's the leadoff hitter of inning number 5, Kelly Gooden, and now back to the top of the order in Perez. Up and out. Perez with a double in the 3rd inning. Also with a stolen base. So she continues to rise up the all-time list at UCLA. She is 2nd all-time with 67 stolen bases in her career.
I really feel like she's been owning that leadoff spot since last weekend when Kinsley Washington did go down and was removed from the lineup. Bruins have had to make certain adjustments with that, plus Aaliyah Jordan and her injury earlier this year, but they've had a lot of people step up. And Bree Perez is definitely one of them.
Yeah, the versatility and depth of the Bruin lineup is pretty special. It's why they are one of the teams that is a favorite to win the national championship this year, because you can mix and match. Coach Inouye Perez missing Aaliyah Jordan, All-American. Part of your lineup is not there. He was injured. Missed the last 19 games in a row as the walk given up to Perez. The 2nd walk earned by Perez in this game. But you mentioned Kinsley Washington, and they do think that the injury is something that is short term. They expect the redshirt senior to be back. Leads the Pac-12 with runs scored, 31. And hitting in just about, feels like every game, is Kinsley Washington. So they miss her in the lineup. But moving things around, and they just continue to roll. Three straight wins against Arizona. Now leading here in the fifth, 3-1. Straight steal there. Olivia Johnson letting that ball hit the dirt. And so no play at second. But another stolen base, her second of the game. So now make it 68 stolen bases.
She's double digits this season now, but that's capitalizing too, and knowing that the catchers are kind of rotating and splitting time, might be trying to get back into a groove. Recognizing that is key.
Little comebacker, and Gabby Plain takes the hot shot, delivers the strike over to Kelly Lynch for out number two. The runner does advance.
Batting fourth, the catcher number 97, Delaney Wynn.
So two down. Lance Glasso, the hitting coach, or excuse me, the pitching coach for the Dogs. Come out and have a conversation. Matt Moore, the lefty. Really done a nice job for the Huskies so far this season. Fifth year senior out of Medford, Oregon, warming up the pen. Gabby playing 68 total pitches in this one, 41 of them strike. She's got 6 Ks, 2 walks. And they gave up 3 earned runs in the first inning. With 2 outs here, I'm assuming unless she gets a little bit of trouble, they'll let her finish this one, and we'll see.
Pat Moore came in game two against Cal. Game one, excuse me, when they got the win. And she did a great job. She was really the reason that they ended up getting that win against the Bears in Berkeley.
Line drive pulled just foul. Delaney Wiz, part of the battery here today with Megan Faramo. And doing damage in the first inning with that RBI double. And came around to score. Trying to add on to this 3-1 Bruin lead. No one trails outside.
Looked like Plain might have been pressing just a little bit. We have that runner on third base to add a little bit of layer of pressure here. Nothing she hasn't dealt with before throughout her career.
So the count even at 1-2 away, but that runner down at third. And this time Wiz takes it down the right field line. Pushes it foul the other way. So Gabby playing ahead in the count now, 1-2. And the 7th K of the evening for Gabby would be a big one with that runner on third and the 3 hitter in the Bruin lineup at the plate. And Wiz fighting that one off. As a pitcher, you see her pull one foul to the left. Push one foul to the right, then goes back left. I don't know where you're trying to locate the ball to get her out.
It's tough when you're facing a gap-to-gap hitter like that. And you might think about changing planes in this situation when you're ahead in the count.
She has reached base safely 20 games in a row, including tonight when she had that RBI double in the first. She struck out against Gabby in the third and took a look at ball two. That's pretty impressive, though. You reach base safely 20 games in a row. That, of course, is the longest streak for UCLA so far this season. This one to the freshman again. She has been delivering strikes across the... They beat Washington 3 out of 4 last year, and they've actually won 9 of the last 10 in this series. And of course, Washington went to the College World Series in 2017, 2018, 2019, 2020, when the season got canceled early. They were one of the best teams in the nation, so UCLA has managed to beat the very best when they've faced off against the Washington Huskies. And Megan Foremo continuing to throw strikes. This is Riley Holtorf, who's really been solid defensively at third base. Hasn't started a lot of games at third. Silent Rain Espinoza has been pretty consistent over there, but with no Sammy Reynolds, who's in concussion protocol. This ball lined, but right to Kelly Gooden, the left fielder for the Bruins. Good contact, good swing.
It's been some solid defense at third base. Holtorf, to your point, Elise, getting a lot of action, showing good range, throwing on the run, like a lot of different tools she's been able to utilize over there. Malaulu made a nice play coming across earlier in the game as well. The hot corner's holding it down.
The swinging bunt there by Vandegrift. Can she beat it out? No, she can't. Close play, and she is gunned down.
Ooh, and there's a lot of conversation about this one. So the speed, one of the only true slappers in these lineups.
Oh,
that was a close play. Take another look. See if the, oh, that almost looked like a, is this a tie should go to the runner situation?
Yeah, that's a bang bang play. The umpires are taught to listen and to not look. You're trying to listen for the foot hitting the bag. And Megan Vandegrift, as close as you're gonna get, trying to beat out that slap.
That's as close a play as I've ever seen. You know, and Heather Tarr coming out having the conversation, just like Kelly I did earlier with another play over at first base.
Heather Tarr, the head coach of the Dogs in her 17th season. Has taken Washington to 7 College World Series in her time. And how about the head coach of the U.S. national team moving forward? Phenomenal stuff for Coach Tarr.
And in international play, you're really working with a roster of 15. That's typically how it works for the Olympics, for example, and she was an assistant for the Tokyo Games this past summer. She said that's helped her now with her 17-person roster this season, with Washington having that versatility and being able to manage players and lineups. That experience has been helpful for her.
So 2 outs here in the fifth for Megan Foremo, the All-American pitcher for the Bruins, facing the true freshman Kinsey Fiedler out of Lee's Summit, Missouri. He struck out in her first 2 at-bats against Foremo, but now ahead of the count 3-0. Had 2 bombs last weekend at Cal. And takes a look on the 3-0 count at strike 1.
Fiedler has reached base for 8 games in a row coming into today's contest, too.
And a big hack there, swinging through it. Primo continuing to keep the Husky offense off balance. Heather Tarr saying that Fiedler, a super talented athlete and plays with a competitive energy that you love. Five tool type of player. And she stays alive. Fouling that one out.
Love just that focus from Megan Framo. That's every single pitch she's competing.
Drives that one down the right field line into the bullpen for UCLA. You see nobody warming up. No need as Framo, 59 pitches in this one. And she has not had to extend herself. Three Ks, no walks. Just one earned run, the solo shot on the first pitch of the at-bat to the outstanding Bailey Klingler all the way back in the first. And Fiedler with a good at-bat drawing the walk. It's kind of fun to see what she can do on the base paths. Fourth in the Pac-12 in stolen bases.
Make it nine games in a row now that she's reached base as well. That's been key for Washington. You got to get the base runners on. That's how you score, right? You have to score to win. Got to try to manufacture something.
And so now, two outs. First base occupied with Fiedler and Bailey Klingler. And that ball getting away. Fiedler takes off and no play as that one bobbled by Delaney Wiz. And she showed no hesitation. She exploded off the bag. What an athlete.
A great read. Seeing that ball in the dirt, she was stealing. Takes the lead. Almost looked like that was a nice lead, actually. Hard off the bag like that. Gave her a good jump to then read that and make it all the way to
second. Ooh, nice piece of hitting there. Straight up the gap for Klingler. Fiedler going for home. And she will slide in. Man. Was she cruising, showing her speed. That wasn't as close as I thought it was going to be. Bailey Klingler gets the Huskies to within one run.
Gotta love that two base mentality, aggressive base running. Put the pressure on. Just a great piece of hitting by Bailey Klingler. We know she's clutch. She goes the other way slightly into center field. Man, the wheels, but that's why drawing
Watch
that
this.
Walk. Drawing that walk was key. Reading that ball in the dirt was key. Put her in scoring position.
Yeah, you mentioned it, just how crucial it is, the walk. First time getting on base today for Fiedler, and she comes around to score. She struck out her first two at-bats. But boy, you could see her speed on display. Hit two bombs last week, and now you see the other side of the equation, the power to go with the speed, and Madison Husky can't connect that time. She had some pretty nasty intentions with that swing, but she's 0-2. Klingler at first. In the bottom of the fifth inning, Husky's trying to get this thing tied up. The first run of the game scored since all the way back in the first. Madison Husky had the double back in the first inning. Underneath that one, fouls it back.
Fans dodged a bullet on that one. Just barely.
We're paying attention. I know the net is up, but it doesn't feel real good when you get drilled in the head with a softball. It's actually not soft at all, in case you're wondering. And a good swing and a miss. The strikeout.
Both sides, at least a little bit so far in this game.
And the Huskies here in the late inning, making a switch behind the plate. Jen Cummings, the 5'10 sophomore, behind the dish now. She's got 17 starts this season at catcher. And caught all three games at Cal as Maya Brady leading things off for the Bruins. And that one hits the outside edge for strike number one.
The thing that they've loved about Jen Cummings is just her ability to be able to manage all five pitchers for this staff for Washington. Coach Tarr said she does some things better than a lot of catchers that they've ever had in this program, which is a huge compliment. She's really a pitcher's catcher, and she just doesn't skip a beat when transitioning in between them.
Well, she is taking the place of one of the all-time best in Morgan Flores. Number 47, nobody will ever forget the power from Morgan Flores and her ability behind the dish. So Jen Cummings last year, Coach Tarr saying it was a huge value that the COVID year, it was a huge surprise. Obviously nobody anticipated that. And so Jen Cummings had to sit behind Morgan Flores for a year and just watch. And she had a chance to watch and learn from one of the best.
And getting to do bullpens with somebody like that, you do learn a ton. You know, I've said before that nothing truly replaces game reps in terms of just getting the repetition in. But being able to see and talk to and learn from a player like that, that's huge for the development of a program.
Brady, you mentioned it. Have not been a lot of free passes given out today, but Maya Brady, with the 9 home runs, has a patient at bat and earns her way down to first base.
Batting second, the first baseman number 11, Seneca.
The Bruins really do want to answer too, just like Washington did in the first, where they came back with something after giving up the 3 runs. When you give up a run in the bottom half of the inning, you want to come back in the top half and make something happen offensively. It was the first run scored last inning since the first.
Ball fouled off, so strike one. Maya Brady at first base, no outs. She does have stolen base potential. She swiped 5 bags this season on 6 attempts. Even though she's got that power, 9 home runs, had 14 home runs last season, tied with Delaney Wiz for the most for the Bruins last season. She can hustle. And strike two as that ball trickles into foul territory. And so now with 2 Ks on at Seneca Kuro. It'd be pretty daring to attempt a bunt now, so the Husky defense can loosen up a little bit, take a step back, and we'll see what Gabby Plain does here ahead 0-2. Curl fouling that one back, staying alive.
You can't throw anything too sweet right now when you know the hitter is trying to protect the plate with 2 strikes. You're ahead. You have some pitches to work with here. Nothing too far over the white of the plate in this situation if you're Gabby Plain.
Ooh, up and in. And the count evens at 2. Or excuse me, 1-2 first ball as she's fouled off 3 in a row.
That's not a bad idea. She's placed that pitch well in some earlier at-bats and batters that she's faced. Just a little bit too out of the zone to fool anyone.
Well, staying alive. 5'7" redshirt sophomore. Verona, California.
All but 3 players on this UCLA roster are from California.
Yeah, I noticed that when prepping. Well, let's face it, UCLA in SoCal has been so good for so long, just decades, that if you're in Southern California and you're a huge softball fan, chances are that your dream is to play at UCLA.
Southern California, really a hotbed for travel softball as well. Definitely other regions in the country that produce amazing talent, but it's been for a very long time one of the go-to places. People even travel out of state to play on a travel ball team from Southern California. So recruit local if you're UCLA.
Saves on the airline miles, that's for sure. Down to second, Cummings, and Brady gets the bag. Her sixth steal in seven attempts this season. Good jump from Maya Brady. And now she is in scoring position with no outs.
She's going all the way. I like the patient approach too. Wait till later in the at bat to utilize the speed, catch them off guard a little bit.
Clay Cummings, maybe a slight hesitation, and I think with Gabby, might have been off speed. So the combination of that, Maya Brady's speed, she takes the bag. McLean coming right back with the strikeout. And that ball in the dirt, so they had
able to get over to third.
And the pitcher today, Megan Faramo. In the box now. Misses inside for ball one.
I like that spot. It did miss a little bit off the plate, but it's not a bad spot if you're Gabby playing, and it's a pitcher's pitch. Trying to graze those corners, or a half a ball off maybe. It's a good take by Faramo at the same time.
One away. Runner in scoring position. Cummings taking that one in. And we'll go to have a visit with Gabby. This is just such a fun young lady, Gabby Plain. When she started in the championship series as a freshman, just smiles, relaxed. The pressure never seems. She's facing the top 10 Bruins right now, number three in the nation. Runner in scoring position. She's at her best when she's just relaxed, cool, having a little bit of fun. And then she comes back with a nice pitch that Faramo swings through.
Inducing a swing and a miss is definitely one of the most fun parts about pitching, but you're right, just very even keeled. And as a softball player, you know, this is a game of failure in a lot of ways. You don't want to get too high or too low at any given point, and Plain does a great job of staying in the middle.
Oh, what a pitch from Plain. Strike two on Faramo.
How cool is this that we get Gabby Plain going up against Megan Faramo at the plate? Like, this is the Pac-12 right here.
All-American versus All-American, although Faramo in the circle is an All-American, but with that true power. And she gets her strike three for Gabby Plain, and that is her eighth strikeout of the game.
Just take a look at that down pitch. So pretty, just her bread and butter.
It was nasty.
Lands below the knees.
Even if Faramo could reach that, there's not a lot you can do with a pitch. That is about 6 inches off the ground. And a Vines. At the plate for her third at-bat today. That one's off the plate. So two down, and Maya Brady, after stealing that base, still at second. Gets her to foul that one back. Vines, great experience in the infield for UCLA, starting second baseman last year. as once again UCLA making it to the College World Series. They've been there 6 seasons in a row. Impressive stuff. Of course, the 2019 national champions. We talked about Washington, their new era with no Sis Bates, no Morgan Flores. Well, for UCLA, no Rachel Garcia. One of the best that we have seen in college softball, there's Sis Bates. Heather Tarr talked about what a superstar Sis Bates is in the world of softball. Everybody knows Sis Bates.
She's a human highlight reel over there at shortstop.
Yeah, she was.
And even since her time here at UW, went right into playing professionally with Athletes Unlimited, put on a great show in that new league.
Yeah, just always talking. That shortstop spot, she'd grind some holes out there, just walking back and forth and spinning around. And it was one of the best defenders we have seen. As Vines drawing the walk. 5-pitch walk for Anna Vines. And so now runners at first and second for Gabby here in the top of the sixth. She's thrown 92 pitches, gone 5 2/3. 8 Ks, 4 walks. So one thing about Gabby playing, 4 walks is a lot for Gabby. She had 6 walks last week, or excuse me, in game 3 against Cal, and just 1 K, which was in 5 seasons wearing the purple and gold. That was by far the worst strikeout to walk ratio we've ever seen from Gabby. But 4 walks is the high mark for Gabby. She doesn't walk people usually, but this UCLA lineup, so powerful and good. You gotta be careful with them.
And one improvement is that she has spread out the walks a little bit in this game versus against Cal. When she had those 6 walks, 3 of them were in a row in the top of the first inning, or the bottom of the first inning, excuse me. So, and that ended up, they ended up paying for that, and that's when Cal scored and got things going offensively, and they had the momentum on their side. Today, she spread them out a little bit throughout the game. The one positive that the Huskies can take from that particular walk is that now there are a couple more options in terms of force plays in the infield. You can tag third base, anything up the middle. You can go to second. You have some options there defensively.
Now, pinch hitter for UCLA, Alyssa Garcia, and she gets underneath this one, and it is out number 3. So
it speaks to the student athlete experience that they had when they were wearing those colors.
Olivia Johnson, good swing, line drive, but right at Maya Brady. That one will be a little bit frustrating when you get a good full barrel and come away with nothing.
You know, outs all look the same in the scorebook at the end of the day, but when you're actually there and watching the game, seeing outs like that, that was a screaming out.
Yeah.
Not all outs are created equal in terms of the way you put the barrel on the ball.
It's more frustrating, a screaming line drive when you get out, or a K when you get caught looking.
Oof.
Yeah, you get out, they all stink.
You're more mad at yourself with the K.
Sure.
At least you're like, all right, I'm on this pitch. I'm on this pitcher, I'm seeing the ball well, my timing's good. You can build off of a screaming out right at somebody, but the K's looking, those are rough.
Yeah, and when you get back to the dugout, nobody's giving you the side eye from the coaching staff. You have a line out, you get caught looking, all of a sudden you're in trouble. Kelly Lynch. A couple of flyouts in the game so far, 0-2. And she is a player, one swing of the bat with her kind of power. She can get this thing tied up. A 5 hitter for the Huskies. A couple of home runs this season. Ooh, and she had a big swing on that one and can't connect. Paramo, just 4 Ks in this one. She is a power pitcher. The Huskies have been able to make contact. But for Paramo, she also has only given up 1 walk. 13 walks this entire season to 153 strikeouts. remarkable. And make it 154 as she gets another one, her fifth K of the game. The crowd doesn't like it, but Faramo says two down.
And this pitch is a great example. Look at that placement. It's a good job by Wiz back there as well.
Yeah.
Sticking it nicely. But this is why she's not only leading the pack in strikeouts, but leading it by such a large margin. You said it earlier, Elise, over 50 Ks difference between her and the next person in line.
Yeah, Gabby Plain is over 100 now. And she entered, I think, at 95 Ks. And so
she
is over 100. She's got eight today, so she's at 103. But for Amo, looking at everybody, Gabby playing third in the Pac-12 in strikeouts. Mariah Maison for Oregon State coming into today had 97.
Well, when you keep in mind, too, that Faramo's just coming up on 90 innings pitched total for the entire season, and that's how many strikeouts she has. It's incredible.
So the pinch hitter at the dish for the Dogs, Sarah Willis. You see the home run power there. Two bombs hitting 256. And the count evens up at 1-1. Two down. Huskies one swing of the bat looking to tie this up. They were behind 3-0 into the bottom of the first, but got a solo home run from Bailey Klingler and added another run in the bottom of the fifth. Kenzie Fiedler coming around to score. And the Bailey Klingler RBI hit. To extend this one, they're going to need at least one more run. And Faramo going upstairs.
Pac-12 Pitcher of the Year from last year. Megan Faramo, part of that 2019 National Championship team. This is a World Series preview in March that we're able to see this weekend.
That's called the Pac-12 Conference.
Yes.
Where eight of the nine teams are either ranked or receiving votes. But of course, this one's pretty special with two teams ranked in the top 10 and two that have been pretty special going back quite a few years. This is the nine hitter in UCLA's lineup, Kelly Gooden. She grounded out to third in her first at bat and then struck out looking in her second at bat. She's got good wheels.
That runs in the family, too. Her brother, Curtis, played baseball and track, ran track at UCLA.
Bruin family. Trying to lay down that bunt, but never got outside of the box.
Did you see? Poking it down the line.
12, as we mentioned, the top 25. The Bruins third, Washington 9, Oregon 12, Arizona dropping to 14th after getting swept, shut out from UCLA. I don't know how fair that is. You drop after that. Arizona State coming in at 20th, Stanford 25th. Oregon State was in the top 25 earlier, and then of course Cal, after taking two of three against the top 10 Huskies, they're also receiving votes.
And even Utah, an extremely scrappy team, got 15-plus wins on the season. You know, they played Oklahoma extremely closely earlier in the preseason this year. They took a game from Oregon in the Pac-12 opening weekend last weekend. You really don't get a weekend off in this conference.
So the 2-2 count to the leadoff batter here in the seventh inning. Oh, and Gabby Plain slips, goes down. Oh, you do not like to see that. She is having a hard time getting up right now. And now comes to her feet, but she definitely looked like she might have turned her ankle, still trying to smile. But Heather Tarr out to check on her All-American. who has kept UCLA's offense off the board. They average over 7 runs a game. Oh, and you saw that right ankle turnover.
She was going to field, you know, be that fifth infielder that we've seen her do several times.
Oh, that'll stun you. And that is a major concern for the University of Washington, as Gabby Plain has been dealing here today. Found her rhythm after that first inning, and she's trying to loosen up that ankle. Oh, you just hate to see that. You hope she's okay. That is a basketball type of injury. This crowd giving her a huge boost, as you could tell, that stung.
You can see the tears welling up a little bit. Ooh. We talked about how even-keeled she is. You know, nothing really phases her, so you know that she felt it.
And that's her push-off. It was her right ankle, and that's her push-off foot. So she's going to give it a couple of warm-up throws and see how she is. But these ankles, they're tricky. She nods her head after that pitch. The crowd, obviously some major concern for the Husky fans in attendance. It's one of the best pitchers in the history of this program. He's been an All-American since setting foot on campus 5 years ago. A tough, tough competitor. And the crowd roars with approval that she's okay. Now coming up next, it's a can't-miss top-ranked Pac-12 men's volleyball matchup. Fifth-ranked SC and 14th-ranked Stanford kick off a 2-game weekend series down by the Bay. Coverage begins next on Pac-12 Network, or download and stream live wherever you might be with Pac-12 Now. So a major sigh of relief for Heather Tarr and this Husky team. Their MVP do everything. You got a chance to beat anybody in the nation with Gabby Plain in the circle. Okay, runner goes, throw down, and they got him. Jen Cummings with a strike down to second, and Fiedler there to apply the tag.
And to me, there's two parts in a play like this. It's getting the throw off by Cummings, and then it's the tag by Fiedler. Look how far down she goes to apply that. And she's fired up right away before they even made the call.
Yeah, what a throw. Cummings did not get the start behind the plate today. They're coming in and gunning out the runner. And taking a little pressure off of Gabby Plain, who had a runner on first and no outs. Gabby Plain coming back, throwing some heat. Even the count at 1.
Talk about letting your defense work and them having your back in that situation. That is huge. If that out's not made, you have a runner in scoring position with the top of the order here for UCLA. So what a momentum shift and some confidence in the back pocket for Gabby Plain now.
And so Kelly Gooden, the speedster, got to first when Gabby Plain kind of turned her ankle trying to make that play and then gets gunned out. She was 6 for 6 in stolen bases before getting hosed out right there. Nice play by Jen Cummings.
And UCLA kept sending them. You know, until the catchers prove that you can gun somebody down, keep doing it. Keep using your speed.
So Brianna Perez, going shortstop, facing a 1-2 count now. We'll see what Gabby Plain does. That one low. Gabby with 8 strikeouts in this one. And although Brianna Perez has earned 2 walks, hit a double, she's got on base all 3 plate appearances. 2 stolen bases, 1 in the 3rd and 1 in the 5th. Gets the bat on this one. Riley Holtorf, once again, delivering across the diamond with ease. Out number 2. I'll tell you, Holtorf, she's getting her shot, and she's had a lot of opportunity there at 3rd today, and she's come up every single time.
she can keep her stick productive in the lineup, she might have found a new home for herself over there at third base.
Well, like everybody in high school, best player on the field, they usually play shortstop. A comebacker to Gabby, and normally she might try to get that one, but instead lets it go through and for the Huskies. Angie Yellen with her first at-bat of the evening. And she takes a look at strike one.
For context, too, Foremo's thrown four perfect games in her entire career. She had two on her own and then the shared one, the combo with Lauren Shaw earlier this season as well. So talk about peaking at the right moment here.
Now, she was unable to pitch last year in the College World Series, which it's just heartbreaking for the Bruins because she was pitching at such a high level, and it kind of pieced things together with some injury issues last year with Rachel Garcia. Holly Azevedo, who we'll probably see tomorrow in the circle, who's off to a great start as well. But for Megan, unable to pitch in the College World Series last year, that's obviously something that you dream about and feel bad she was unable to go. Nice job by Yellen to get her bat on that and stay alive in a 1-2 count.
Coach Inoue Perez talked about how when your pitchers are throwing this well, you just got to get a few runs, you know, let the defense work. You just need to get enough to win some ball games, and they really are the top pitching duo in the country right now, the only pitching duo that have double-digit wins each.
Yellen, as this one stays fair? Yes, it does. Nice play by Delaney Wiz to flip around and take the pop-up from Angie Yellen, 5'7 freshman with her first at-bat. Nice pinch hitting option for Heather Tarr. She's hitting over 400. And now Riley Holtorf, who's really played well defensively. And sometimes that carries over. Just misses that one underneath it. Timed it well, straight back.
Anytime you're successful on one side of the ball, if you can bring that energy into the other side, it's very, very possible. She's been absolutely on fire in the hot corner today.
A 5'8 freshman had a home run against Colorado State earlier this season. That one trails low for ball one.
Coach Tarr talked a lot about how even as a freshman, really a leader on the team, makes eye contact, has good communication, all the things that you identify as Husky softball.
And she sends that one foul into the Husky bullpen for strike two. 1-2 count, and Foremo is in charge. She's gonna have to fight off one of Foremo's best pitches now.
We've zoomed in a few times on this, and it's so, so cool, which is Megan Framo's earrings. Really cool. They say UCLA there, straight in her ear. That is awesome.
That is really neat. The UCLA script. You can recognize that even from up above. Holtorf. Looks like that ball might have kind of tipped up, got her in the face mask. The home plate umpire here today asking if she's okay. That's Mike Bartling. He's done a nice job calling balls and strikes here today. You always know, you haven't heard the home crowd giving too many groans, so it's usually an indicator. Oh, that one is laced, but way early. A long strike.
And sometimes that can be a setup pitch in these situations. You go in on her, get her to foul something off, and then you go out or you throw something up, some rise ball.
Husky offense down to two outs to try to tie things up. And she gets her on the inside. Another strikeout for Ramo.
That rise ball has been working for her so well. Been her strikeout pitch several times in this game. It just rises above the barrel. No chance. See how it landed right, even with the helmet basically at the top of the head there.
Not only does it have velocity, but that thing rising up out of the zone. Really tough to catch up to it. And so Holtorf goes down swinging, and the Huskies are down to their final out. Jen Cummings coming in relief for Olivia Johnson.
You talk about defensive momentum carrying over ideally into the offense after getting good and caught stealing over at second base. That's what Cummings is hoping for now.
Swinging right through that offering from Faramo, and now it's 0-2, one strike away for UCLA to have another top 25 win under their belt. And she got her. Faramo with her 8th K to end it.